This is the world's scariest barbershop. Anyone who have ever walked in never walk out alive. The emotionless barber would take out knife and instead of shaving their beard, he slit their throat. Then he stepped onto a switch that sent the cops to their kitchen downstairs through a trap door. Yet below the barbershop is the city's most famous meat pie restaurant. And the meat pie is always so delicious, the customers would always return for more. And people have always asked the lady boss for her recipe, but she never talked about it. Since there's plenty of people in the restaurant, there are also more and more customers going into the barbershop, creating a self-sustaining cycle. Now, the person in charge of the murder is named Todd, and he hasn't always been this cruel. 15 years ago, Todd was a really happy young man. He takes care of his family as a barber, and his wife is this incredibly beautiful blonde with a cute little baby daughter. But too bad, the good didn't last very long. The judge has been eyeing on Todd's beautiful wife, and he wanted Todd's wife as his own instead. So, he framed Todd with some criminal charges and exiled him out of the country. And after being exiled for 15 years, Todd came back to London. He swore to himself that he was going to kill the judge and take back what belongs to him. After he parted ways with his young buddy, he came back to the barbershop he once owned. 15 years later, the barbershop is now a meat pie shop. At a glance, the hygiene of the restaurant is absolutely horrendous. However, the lady boss gave him a rather friendly greeting. And once the lady boss took a good look at Todd, she immediately recognized the person in front of her was Todd, the man who was framed. From her, Todd learned that the judge has claimed his wife as his own through some dirty tactics, and his wife couldn't bear the humiliation after being violated, so she killed herself by drinking poison. Yet, the judge didn't stop there. He trapped their daughter by using his name as a stepfather, and he also planned to marry the daughter once she has grown up. Afterward, the lady boss returned Todd with his old razor. On the other side, the young buddy looked at the judge's stepdaughter, who is going to be his fiancée. The beautiful blonde smiled back at him, and young buddy fell in love with her. However, a crazy woman walked towards him and told him that the stepdaughter has been locked up for 15 years, and her name is Johanna. For the past 15 years, Johanna didn't dare to interact with too many people, because anyone who has had desire for her would be punished severely. Just as the crazy woman finished her words, the mansion's door opened. It was the judge, and he welcomed the young buddy in. And of course, they are not there to eat meat pie. The judge warned him not to interact with Johanna, and his underling gave him a good beating behind the door. The young buddy swore that he would rescue Johanna instead. On the other side, we have a fox barber who is selling a fake hair tonic that smells horrendous. Looking at how his lies were exposed, the fox barber started saying that he's the world's best barber instead. Todd challenged him to a barber contest, and while the fox barber was still boasting about his skills, Todd had already finished and won the contest. Todd was announced as the victor, and his reputation was soon known by many. With this opportunity, Todd restarted his barbershop business. Todd's plan was that once the judge becomes his customer, he will kill him. Yet, the fox barber showed up at Todd's barbershop and stated that he recognized Todd's razor as he was Todd's previous assistant 15 years ago. The fox barber took this opportunity to blackmail him, saying that if you want to stay here and not be brought to the judge as an exiled criminal, you got to share 50% of your profit with me. Enraged, Todd took the water kettle and smashed onto the fox barber's head. At this point in time, the fox barber's apprentice was still calmly eating meat pie downstairs. After hearing some noise and sensing that something could be wrong, he ran upstairs, but the fox barber was nowhere to be found. All that seen was just Todd calmly drinking his tea. But what's not seen was that behind him was a person's hand inside a box that's still twitching. Todd asked the apprentice to go out and finish his business. Interestingly, the judge decided to visit Todd's barbershop for a haircut right after that. Despite being so old, the judge is still doing a lot of evil things. Raping, killing, robbing, stealing, cheating. He even punished a kid with death penalty for running into him. As mentioned, he used dirty tricks to force Todd's wife to become his. And now he wants to force the marriage onto Todd's daughter, so he decided to get a good haircut with Todd. Just as Todd was about to slit his throat, the young buddy shouted at the judge that he was going to elope with Johanna. Apparently, the young buddy really lacks common sense, because why would you announce your secret plan to your enemy? No idea. Maybe he knocks his head when he was growing up. The judge blamed Todd for whatever that has happened and swore not to visit this barbershop again. Looking at how he lost his only opportunity for revenge, Todd chased his young buddy out. Now, the lady boss discusses with Todd on how to handle the dead body. Just as they were wondering, the lady boss spoke about how the meat pie shop opposite them always have really good business. Yet, she knew their dirty trick. They use cat meat. So the lady boss came up with a rather innovative idea. We are going to use human meat. The volume is also a lot higher compared to a cat meat. Todd thought that this was a brilliant business plan, so he started modifying his barber chair with a secret switch. Once he killed his customer, he would step onto the switch and send his customer's corpse into the kitchen. With this strategy, the barber and restaurant's business prospered. While most customers still visit the restaurant, the crazy lady sensed something wasn't right from the black smoke from the chimney. She asked most people not to visit the restaurant, for she knew the food wasn't clean. But who cares about that when you can enjoy delicious cannibalistic meat pie? On the other side, the judge got rather enraged after receiving the news that his Johanna wanted to elope with another man. He punished her by sending her to a mental asylum. And the young buddy, having run out of ideas, asked Todd for help. And Todd had an idea. Some of the barber would actually go into the insane asylum to get the patient's hair as a wig. He suggested that he could rescue Johanna through that method. Of course, Todd wasn't doing that out of goodwill. He reported the young buddy's plan to the judge so he could regain the favor of the judge and kill him again when the opportunity is right. He asked the young apprentice, who is now working at the restaurant, to send the letter out for him. The young apprentice has always been afraid of Todd because he noticed that some customers step into the barbershop but never step out. And one day, the young apprentice happened to be eating a meat pie that they have just cooked and noticed a finger inside. Then it struck him. All this pile of bodies, they are human corpses. Just when he is horrified, another body fell from the trapdoor into the kitchen and he tried to get out as soon as he can, but no matter how he knocked, no one responded to him. And a few minutes ago, the judge underling has came to inspect their kitchen because someone has complained about how the black smoke from the restaurant releases some really horrible stench. So, the lady boss was a little nervous, but Todd calmly invited him to have a haircut first before the spot check. And of course, he got his throat slit and sent down to the kitchen. Next. Now, the lady boss and Todd realizes that the young apprentice now knows their secrets, so they decided to finish him off. Yet, the young apprentice was nowhere to be found in the kitchen. And at the same time, the young buddy has rescued Johanna to now be his fiancée and came to Todd again for help. Since Todd wasn't here, he asked Johanna to wait as he go and find Todd. When Johanna hears footsteps approaching her, she was afraid that it was the judge who was here for her, so she hid inside the box. But the person who arrived wasn't the judge. Instead, it was the crazy woman. When Todd arrived, the crazy woman looked really surprised, as if she knew him. Todd didn't quite care because all that he was thinking about is to slit the throat of the judge who is coming over here right now. So, he just killed the crazy woman without thinking. So, this crazy woman became another meat pie material. At last, the judge arrived and Todd lied to him that he had already captured Johanna for him. So, might as well get a nice haircut before his marriage. The judge was convinced and he sat down without even thinking. And lo and behold, Todd announces who he was and started stabbing into the judge's throats. The years of hatred are now avenged. After killing the judge, Todd realizes that Johanna was hiding and saw the whole process. Having been separated for 15 years, Todd couldn't recognize her at all as his own daughter. But right when Todd was about to kill her, the lady boss shouted from the floor below because the judge grabbed her dress. Todd let Johanna go temporarily and went downstairs. But to Todd's surprise, he realized that the crazy woman has this beautiful blonde hair and she was actually Todd's wife all along. She got enraged at the lady boss who faked the news that his wife was dead because lady boss wanted Todd all to her own. Todd pretends to forgive her, have a dance, and hurl her into the bakehouse oven as revenge. So the lady boss was burned to her death. Seeing all that has happened, the young apprentice appeared from his hiding place and killed Todd, putting an end to his serial murder. What's the moral of the story? Well, maybe we should all just cut our own hair instead.